Spring marks the beginning of nesting season here on the northern Gulf Coast. And soon, turtles will be coming up onto this beach and hopefully laying lots of eggs. But there's still oil left on this beach. And the heavy equipment used to remove it now has to get off.
This auger picks up the sand from the beach at a prescribed depth.
They call them land sharks, and they've been deep cleaning the sand all winter long.
It's amazing how clean that is.
It's beautiful. These Florida beaches are spectacular.
The goal is to get the beaches back to their pre-oil spill form. But layers of oil still exist deep in the sand, and these machines are only allowed to dig down 6 inches in this wildlife protected area.
So there's a lot more going on in the sand than just
meets
the eye.
It is. It's very live. It's a very active substrate. It's very diverse. What we can't see is a lot of other critters, literally, that are below us right now that all drive this whole system.
All of what makes this perfect nesting grounds for some rare animals. I got to handle a few sea turtles rescued from the oil spill last year. They are truly remarkable creatures.
Pretty darn cute. Turtles that are born on this beach, do they come back and nest on this beach?
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. They imprint on this area by virtue of when they hatch.
So they don't really have a choice. This is their nesting ground, oil or not, they're going to come back here.
This is their habitat and home, absolutely.
This stretch of beach averages about 2,000 baby turtles that hatch in the sand and crawl back into the Gulf every year. The hope is this year, when the turtles do come home, the little oil that's still here won't get in their way.